As of November 26 of 2023, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is Japan's famous Iwo Jima volcano, which during the last month formed the world's newest volcanic island. This ash-rich new island appears to be around 8 acres in size and is actively producing black and white Sersaean explosions. The presence of lava fragments is interesting as it marks Iwo Jima's only second magmatic eruption since historical records of this volcano began. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Russia, the world's fastest-growing volcano lost about 150 feet in height as it was revealed that significant changes occurred to its summit region following a powerful eruption on October 31st. Meanwhile, in the Northern Mariana Islands, a major earthquake seemingly triggered earthquakes underneath a scenic volcanic caldera. And, in what is this week's top story, the Ulawun volcano in Papua New Guinea produced a powerful subplinian eruption, representing what was this volcano's either second or third most powerful eruption in its recorded history. This major eruption occurred at 3:24 p.m. local time on November 20th when the Ulawun volcano on the island of New Britain produced a powerful explosion, sending a sustained plume of ash to a height of 50,000, then 60,000 feet. As part of this eruption column, which was heavier than residual air, subsequently collapsed back to the ground, it generated long-reaching pyroclastic flows which traveled at least 4,340 meters, incinerating an area of approximately 7.3 square kilometers. While the eruption has since subsided, at least 580 square kilometers of land containing many crucial palm oil trees which supply the local economy have been ruined for the season due to the fact that this marks where about an inch or 2.5 centimeters thick of ash fell. Due to this volume, I have estimated that this subplinian event ejected 0.025 cubic kilometers of tephra, meaning the eruption had a volcanic explosivity index of a 3. However, this eruptive event is potentially not quite over and more evacuations could be eventually required due to the potential for additional similarly large explosions during the next 2 to 4 months. As the last time a similar sized eruptive sequence occurred was in 2019, and that involved several powerful explosions, two of which were of about an equal size to the November 20th event, occurring across a 3.5-month-long period. Meanwhile, in Russia, about a month after a major explosive eruption occurred at the Klyuchevskoy volcano, we are only just now learning the effects that this subplinian eruption had. Klyuchevskoy towered to a height of 4,788 meters high and contained a 332 meter wide and 60 meter deep central crater. Well, as of mid-November, it appears that the October 31st eruption caused Klyuchevskoy to lose 45 meters or 147.6 feet in height, expanding the existing crater to 553 meters wide and 300 meters deep. Additionally, it appears that the pyroclastic flows from that eruption incinerated 39.7 square kilometers, traveling furthest towards the southeast. There, they were so energetic that they destabilized a part of the mountainside, forming a 50 to 100 meter deep ravine which now extends for 2,700 meters. Pyroclastic flows traveled at least 9,800 meters down that same drainage, while a spot 66 kilometers downriver to the west-southwest experienced a notable lahar. While Klyuchevskoy's eruption has been officially declared as over, heat signatures suggest that it may still be weakly undergoing some form of eruptive activity. In the Northern Mariana Islands, a strong magnitude 6.9 earthquake struck at 10 miles or 16 kilometers depth on November 24th. Thankfully, the quake did not generate any tsunamis and did not cause any damage due to the lack of any populations on immediately adjacent islands. This strike-slip earthquake in the days since has been followed by numerous aftershocks, including 12 magnitude 5 and 7 magnitude 4 quakes. While such aftershocks are fully to be expected after large magnitude earthquakes, I wish to highlight two of these magnitude 5 aftershocks. Simply put, the magnitude 5.3 and magnitude 5.2 quakes occurred in incredibly close proximity to a major volcanic caldera known as the Maug Islands and seemed suspicious. Although this is not the most likely cause, there is a legitimate possibility that the nearby main shockwave triggered some magma movement underneath the Maug Islands, which have probably erupted since the end of the last ice age but have no known historical eruptions. Yet, because these islands are so remote, we cannot really tell if this is the case, so I am adding the Maug Islands on my informal volcanic unrest list under the lowest category still signifying some potential form of volcanic unrest, aka the slight unrest category. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 26th of 2023. Please subscribe as it helps out this channel. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.